Thyroid medullary carcinoma is a malignant tumor of the thyroid gland derived from the C cells or parafollicular cells, which are the neuroendocrine cells producing calcitonin. This is the residual parenchyma of the thyroid gland, and here we have the tumor. So let's go closer. And here we have very prominent deposition of amorphous hyalinized pink material. And this is amyloid. It would show positivity for Congo red, and it would show apple green birefringence in the polarized light. Amyloid deposition is probably the most useful clue in diagnosing medullary carcinoma. However, it is not present in all of the cases. And here we see these lesional neoplastic cells that typically have a plasmacytoid appearance. So they have relatively uniform round nuclei, which are eccentrically located in the relatively voluminous cytoplasm. Medullary carcinoma can be associated with multiple variable patterns. It is a very variable tumor, so the plasmacytoid appearance of the cells is probably the second most useful clue after amyloid deposition. The neoplastic cells are basically neuroendocrine cells, so they have the classical nuclear features of the neuroendocrine tumors, which means we can find stippled chromatin or salt and pepper-like chromatin in the nuclei and small inconspicuous nucleoli. The cytoplasm is typically voluminous and it can be granular. Some of the cells have darker cytoplasm, some of these cells have lighter cytoplasm, but the granular appearance because of the content of neuroendocrine granules is quite characteristic. Now we can see the solid arrangement of cells or solid type of growth. Sometimes we can see insular pattern where these cells are organized in the small solid nests encircled by these thin fibrovascular septi. Here we have something that slightly resembles papillary type of growth. Sometimes the cells can be discohesive. We can see variable amount of fibrosis. And here we have again the amyloid deposition. Because the cells produce calcitonin, they would be positive for the calcitonin on immunohistochemistry, and they are neuroendocrine cells, so they would be positive for neuroendocrine markers like chromogranin and synaptophysin. Sometimes we can find these calcifications that can resemble somoma bodies, but we usually do not see concentric lamination of these calcified foci. Sometimes we can find the infiltration of these normal thyroid follicles by these neoplastic cells. Medullary carcinoma can be sporadic or familial, and familial cases are usually associated with MEN2A and MEN2B syndromes, so multiple endocrine and neoplasia syndromes. In that case, they are usually multiple, and they are associated with a germline mutation of RET oncogene. Clinically, we can usually see the elevated levels of the calcitonin. Thanks for watching.